Good morning, students. Welcome back to English class. Students, today we are going to see a new chapter in grammar, that is chapter 19, conjunctions. So all of you, be ready with your English grammar book. Students, today's topic is conjunction. Okay, what do you mean by conjunctions? Conjunction is a part of speech. Okay, just like a noun, verb, pronoun, adverb, adjective, like. And the basic purpose, it means the basic usage of a conjunction is to combine words or sentences. Okay, the basic purpose of a conjunction is to combine words or a group of words or a sentences. What do you mean by conjunction? A conjunction is a word or group of words which join, which connects words or group of words together. Okay, students, look at the given example here. I need a bat and a ball. The given example is I need a bat and a ball. Here, and is used as a conjunction because it connects two words, bat and a ball. So I need a bat and a ball. Students, look here, some conjunctions are here. Let us see what are they. And, or, but, because, so, if, though. Okay, let us read again. And, or, but, because, so, if, though. Students, these are conjunctions. Let us see these conjunctions in detail. Students, let us see the conjunction and in detail. Okay, the conjunction and is used to join similar words or groups of words. What do you mean by, what is the usage of the conjunction and? The conjunction and is used to join similar words, similar ideas or groups of words. Okay, students, let us see an example here. Tom came to my party. This is one sentence, okay? Tom came to my party. Max came to my party. This is another sentence. Again, I'm reading the two sentences. Tom came to my party. Max came to my party. Students, have you found the similarities in the sentences? Yes, both the people are coming to my party. Okay, idea is same. The two people, Tom and Max, are doing the same action. That is, they are coming to my party. So we can use the conjunction and to combine the two sentences into a single sentence. Tom and Max came to my party. Tom and Max came to my party. Okay, students, let's move to the next conjunction, that is or. Now we are going to see the conjunction or in detail. Okay, the conjunction or is used to show choice. What do you mean by, what is the usage of conjunction or? It is used to show choice. It means it is used to offer a choice or opinion. Okay, let us see an example here. The given example is, do you want coffee or tea? In the given example, we offer two choices. One is coffee, another one is tea. You have to choose any one. So it offers a choice. Do you want coffee or tea? That is your opinion. You can choose any one of the two. So the conjunction or is used to show choice or it offers an opinion. Students, now we are going to the next conjunction, that is but. Now we are going to see the conjunction but in detail. The conjunction but is used to show opposition. Opposition means opposite. just now only we have seen that the conjunction and is used to join similar ideas or similar words. Okay, now we are going, but the conjunction but is opposite to the conjunction and. Already said that and is used to combine similar words or ideas, but is used to connect contrasting ideas or things. It means the conjunction but is used to connect contrasting, means different, opposite ideas or opposite things. Okay, let us see an example here. The given example, it means the first sentence is Mr. John is strict, and the next sentence is Mr. John is kind. It shows the different characters of a same person. Okay, Mr. John is strict, and Mr. John is strict, Mr. John is kind. Two different qualities of a same person. So now we are going to combine these two sentences into a single sentence using the conjunction but, because the person has two different qualities. Mr. John is strict but kind. Okay students, again I'm repeating, the conjunction but is used to show opposition or contrasting, it is used to connect contrasting ideas or things. Students, let us see the next conjunction, that is because. The conjunction because is used to show the reason. It is used to show the reason. Okay students, look at the given example. He is crying because he is hurt. The given example is he is crying because he is hurt. Already I said that the conjunction because is used to show the reason behind something. Look here, he is crying. Why is he crying? Because he is hurt. So there is a reason behind crying. So that's why we have used the conjunction because. He is crying because he is hurt. Because it means there is a reason behind something, behind crying. Let us see the next conjunction, that is so. The conjunction so is used to show the result. It is used to show the result. Okay students, look at the given example. That is I was hungry, so I made a sandwich for myself. The given example is I was hungry, so I made a sandwich for myself. So it shows the result. It means he was hungry, so he made a sandwich for himself. So it shows the result of his hungry. Okay students, let's move to the next conjunction, that is if. The usage of the conjunction if to show the condition. The conjunction if is used to show the condition. It introduces what to do in the event that something happens. It introduces what to do in the event that something happens. It shows the condition. Okay, let us see the example. The given example is you can go to the park if it does not rain. So look here, there is a condition in the sentence. You can go to the park. Okay, you can go to the park if it does not rain. So what actually the sentence tells us that if it does not rain, you can go to the park. If it rains, you cannot go to the park. Okay, so this is the usage of the conjunction if. You can go to the park if it does not rain. So the condition applies here. Okay students, let's move to the next conjunction, that is though. The conjunction though is used to show contrast. Contrast means, already I explained that, different or opposite. The conjunction though is often used to describe a contrasting situation. Okay, students, let us see the example. The given example is, though she was scared, she fought bravely. Though she was scared, she fought bravely. Okay, students, when we are using the conjunction though, it introduces two contrasting statements. We have seen the two contrasting statements in the given example also, because the two statements are totally contrasting. So that's why we have used the conjunction though. Students, again, I'm repeating again, the conjunction though is used to show contrast. Okay, students, now we are going to do the book bag exercises. Before going to do the main exercise, let's do a warm-up exercise. That is, can you do more than one thing at the same time? Look at what Tanya can do. Then write two sets of different activities that you can do at the same time. Students, they are asking us that write two sets of different activities that we can do at the same time. Look here, Tanya can sing and dance at the same time. Tanya can read and write at the same time. We have to write two sets of different activities that we can do at the same time. For example, we can write that I can travel and listen to music at the same time. This is one type of activity, two different activities we can do at the same time. The same like that, you can write any two sets of activities that you can do at the same time. And we have used the conjunction and here because already I explained that it is used to join two groups of words. Okay, students, you have to write two sets of activities that you can do at the same time. Write neatly and clearly. Students, now we are going to do the first exercise, that is fill in the blanks with the given conjunctions. Some conjunctions can be used twice. Students, one helping box is also there. Let us see what are the conjunctions I have given inside the box. They are but, or, because, and, so, if. Students, these are the conjunctions they are given inside the box. Look here, some conjunctions we can use twice also. Already they have given in the title, some conjunctions can be used twice. If necessary, we can use the same conjunction further another sentence also. Let us see the first one. He is intelligent dash wise. He is intelligent dash wise. Students, which conjunction is suitable for the first one? Which conjunction we can use for the first one? He is intelligent and wise. Already I have explained that the conjunction and is used to combine two similar ideas or two similar things. In the first sentence, they show that two similar qualities of a person, that is intelligent and wise. That's why we have used the conjunction and. The answer for the first one is and. He is intelligent and wise. Let's move to the second one. I had to throw away the food dash the mouse had eaten some of it. So which is the correct answer for the second sentence? I had to throw away the food. I had to throw away the food because the mouse had eaten some of it. Already we know that the usage of the conjunction because to show the reason behind something. So there is a reason behind throwing away the food, because the mouse had eaten some of it. That's why thrown away the food. Okay, so the answer for the second one is because. Let's move to the next one. The carpenter was unwell dash left work early. So which one is suitable for the third one? The carpenter was unwell, it means not well. The carpenter was not well, so left work early. It shows the result. He was not well, so left work early. The answer for the third one is so. Let's move to the fourth one. Would you like to go to a park dash watch a film? Already I said that the conjunction or is used to it offers a choice or an option. So in the fourth sentence, they offer two choices. One is go to a park, another one is watch a film. So two options are given. If anyone offers choices to us, we have to use the conjunction or. Would you like to go to a park or watch a film? The answer for the fourth one is or. Students, the first four sentences are over. Remaining four are there. You can try in your grammar book. Write neatly. Okay, students, let's move to the next exercise. That is, join the sentences using the given conjunctions. Students, here, sentences are given. We have to combine two sentences into a single sentence with the help of given conjunctions inside the brackets. Okay, let us do the first one. Mr. Sinha is old. He is very fit. Two sentences, okay? The two sentences talk about the qualities, two different qualities of the same person, Mr. Sinha. Mr. Sinha is old. He is very fit. Two different qualities. Already I explained that the conjunction but is used to combine two different qualities. So in the first sentence, we are going to use the conjunction but. Look here. Mr. Sinha is old but fit. Mr. Sinha is old but very fit. Let's move to the second one. Robin went to the mall. Robin went to the mall. He bought gift for his sisters. And the given conjunction inside the bracket is and. So with the help of the conjunction and, we have to combine these two sentences into a single sentence. Robin went to the mall and bought gifts for his sisters. Robin went to the mall and bought gifts for his sisters. Let's move to the next one. We will go to Jaipur for the holidays. This is one sentence. We will go to Mumbai for the holidays. This is another sentence. They have given the conjunction or. So students, with the help of the conjunction or, we have to combine these two sentences into single sentence. Already we know that the conjunction or is used to offer choices. So the answer is we will go to Jaipur or Mumbai for the holidays. So this is an option only because we will go to Jaipur or Mumbai for the holidays. We will go to Jaipur or Mumbai for the holidays. Let's move to the next one. I am tired. I was practicing for the annual function all day. The given conjunction is because. With the help of given conjunction, we have to combine these two sentences to frame a single sentence. I am tired because I was practicing for the annual function all day. Already we know that the conjunction because is used to show the reason. So the reason is he was tired because he was practicing for the annual function all day. Students, the first four sentences over remaining four are there. With the help of given conjunctions inside the brackets, you can combine two sentences into a single one, a single sentence. So students, write neatly and clearly. Okay students, we have completed two exercises. Now we are going to see some conjunctions with its meaning or usage of the conjunctions in detail. Let us see the first conjunction, that is though. Already I explained, but again I'm repeating, again I'm giving explanation about the conjunction though. It is used to show contrast. It is used to describe a contrasting situation. Okay, let's move to the next one. Until. The conjunction until is used to, the meaning of the conjunction until is up to the time that mentioned. Up to the time that mentioned. It means we use until to connect an action or an event to a point in time. It refers to time. Okay, it refers to the time that mentioned. Let's move to the next conjunction, that is unless. Unless means except if. We use unless to say that there may be an exception case, and that the exception will change the situation. What do you mean by unless? It means when we use the conjunction unless to say that there may be an exception, and that the exception will change the entire situation. Let's move to the next conjunction, that is since. It is used to talk about a starting time. It refers time, not distance. Okay, it is used to talk about a starting time of an action in the past, and that action still continues until now. It means this present time. Let's move to the next conjunction, that is while. While shows us that something happens at the same time. It shows us that something happens at the same time, something else is happening. And it also used to express, it can express contrast things. What is the usage of the conjunction while? While is used to express contrast things at the same time. It shows us that something happens at the same time, something else is also happening. Let's move to the next conjunction, that is when. Already we know that when is used to ask questions related to time. For example, when will you go? When did you leave the place? Like this. And the conjunction when is used as a when as a conjunction, it means at the time that. Let's move to the last conjunction, that is after. Already we know that after means later. So here we use after as a conjunction. It means at a time later than something. It means when something has finished. Okay students, now we have seen some extra more conjunctions. Let us see the examples of these conjunctions. Okay students, just now only we have seen some extra conjunctions with its meaning and usage. Now we are going to see that conjunctions used as examples. Look here how they connect two ideas in a sentences. Here we have given examples, some examples using the conjunctions. Look at the example. He came to school though he had fever. Already I said that the conjunction though is used to describe a contrasting situations. So in the first example, two contrasting situations are there. So that's why we have used the conjunction though. Let's move to the next one. Do not submit your notebook until you finish your work. Students, already I told that when we use the conjunction until to connect an action to a point in time. It refers to time that mentioned. So until you finish your work, do not submit your notebook. So the time that mentioned. Okay, let's move to the next one. He won't shut the windows unless you remind him about it. Already we know that unless means except. When we use the conjunction unless to say that the exceptions will change the situation. Okay, let's move to the next one. I have not seen Pranav since he left home in the morning. Since means it is used to talk about starting time of an action. Since is used to talk about starting time of an action in the past and still continues still now. Okay, let's move to the next one. It started raining while I was waiting at the bus stop. Students, while shows that something happens at the same time, something else is happening. It can express contrast things. It started raining in the middle of raining. He was waiting at the bus stop. So while shows that something happens at the same time, something else is also happen. Let's move to the next one. Please give her my message when you meet her. It means we know very well that when is used to ask questions. So here, when we use when as a conjunction, it means at the time that. Okay, it means when you meet her, please give her my message to that time. It refers at that time. Let's move to the last example. That is, I will go home after the cricket match is over. After means generally the meaning of after is later. So here, when we use after as a conjunction, it means when something has finished. When something has finished, it means I will go home after the cricket match is over. Students, we have seen the examples of some conjunctions. Okay, students, let's move to the next exercise. That is, fill in the blanks with the correct conjunctions. Students, two options are given inside the brackets. We have to write the correct answer. It means we have to select the correct answer from the given two options. Let us see the first one. I reached home - it stopped raining. Two options are given. One is after and the next option is since. So students, which option is suitable for the first one? Yes, you're right, after, because I reached home after it stopped raining. Already we know that after means when something is over we have to do the next. So I reached home after it stopped raining. Let's move to the next one. I have not read a comic book - my exams began last week. In the second one also two options are there. One is when and another one is since. So which is the correct option, correct answer? I have not read a comic book since my exams began last week. Already we know that since is used to show the starting point of an action. So here the correct answer for the second one is since. Let's move to the third one. My neighbor fell sick - he was on vacation. Two options are since, while. So which one is correct for the third one? My neighbor fell sick - he was on vacation. Yes, you're right, while. Because already I told, while shows that something happens at the same time, something else is also happens. So the third one, my neighbor fell sick while he was on vacation. Okay, let's move to the fourth one. He went out dash it became dark. Students, two options are until, after. So which is the correct answer for the fourth one? He went out after it became dark. After means later. Okay, let's move to the fifth one. Give the book to Sneha dash you meet her. Options are while, when. Already we know that when is used to ask questions, and when we use when as a conjunction meaning at the time. At the time that action happens. So give the book to Sneha when you meet her. Let's move to the sixth one. I cannot go out in the evening dash my father lets me. So students, two options are unless, but. So which is the correct answer for the sixth one? I cannot go out in the evening unless my father lets me. Unless means except. We can use unless to say that the exception will change the situation. So the answer for the sixth one is unless. I cannot go out in the evening unless my father lets me. Let's move to the seventh one. Dash, she was hurt. She walked home. Two options are until, though. So students, though is used to show contrast. To show the contrast. Used to describe a contrasting situation. So yeah, the two situations are in contrast mode. Okay. So the answer is though. Though she was hurt, she walked home. Students, the third exercise is over. So write the answers neatly. Students, all the exercises are over. Now we are going to see an interesting activity for you. That is letters write. Look here. Complete the letter from Minu to her brother Manish about the sports day in her school. Students, actually it is a letter, but it is not completed. It is not fully completed. So what we have to do means, with the help of conjunctions, we have seen some basic conjunctions and how to use that conjunctions. So with the help of that conjunctions, you can fill the letter. Then only it will become a fulfilled letter. So students, complete the letter with the help of conjunctions. Write neatly. Students, now we came to an end. It means recap corner. Today we have seen a new chapter, that is conjunctions. We know that conjunctions are words which join words, sentences or groups of words. Okay, we have seen some basic conjunctions. They are and, or, but, because, so, if, though, unless, after, while. That's all, students. And let us see these conjunctions in brief. And is used to join similar words. Okay, the conjunction or is used to show choice or offers the choice. The conjunction but is used to show opposition. Opposition means it is used to combine two different words or two different ideas. The conjunction because is used to show the reason behind something. The conjunction so, it is used to show the result. The conjunction if, used to show the condition. The conjunction though, it is used to describe a contrast situation. The conjunction until, used to show the time that mentioned. The conjunction unless, it is used to show that the exception will change the situation. The conjunction since, it is used to talk about the starting time of an action and the action still continues. The conjunction while, it is used to shows that something happens at the same time something else is also happen, and it can express the contrast also. The what is that? The last conjunction after, it is used to show that later, when something has finished. Students, we have seen the basic conjunctions and its usages also. We have seen exercises and we have done many activities also. Students, I gave answers for all the exercises of this chapter after completing it. That means after writing all the answers for all the exercises, you can check the answers here. Students, today we have seen a new chapter in grammar, that is chapter 19, conjunctions. I hope you understood the concept. You should practice the exercises, then only you can easily understand the concept. We will meet on next class with another topic. Thank you.